Let me show you how you can automate Reoon email verifier. This one is the email verification system that's going to let you know if the email is actually valid or not. And the idea is to automate the process so it's done automatically. When someone fills out a form, it's going to verify it automatically. When someone fills out a form for a giveaway, for any particular reason you grab an email, you can actually verify it automatically using their API. Now, it might sound kind of hard, but it's not. I'm going to show you how right now. I'm going to show you how to automate the process with Reoon. And right now it's on a lifetime deal, and it's actually a pretty sweet deal, which I want to show you before I show you how to automate. So it starts off at $79 for the lifetime deal. And let me show you really quickly what that gets you, because it's actually pretty good. So for example, plan one, which is $79, gets you access to 500 credits per day. So that means that you can verify 500 emails per day, every single day, lifetime. So that's all you have to pay once, and that's all. But you also get an additional 100,000 lifetime credits in the beginning. So those don't renew, okay? But the good part about it is that if you already have an email list that you need to verify, well, you have those 100K, then you have your 500 daily ones, okay? So that's pretty cool. If you need more, jump into plan two or three. I bet most of us are fine with plan one. So just consider that. So let me jump over. This is my Reoon account. And like I said, I'm going to show you how to automate with API. Now, it sounds hard, but it's actually pretty easy. And for this, I'm going to show you in Pabbly Connect, okay? So let's go into my API settings. And in API settings, we have the requests that we can use. So they have two kind of verification modes. One is the quick mode, and the other one, I think they call it super mode. Here we go, the power mode, okay? So there's two type of links, this one and the other one. So basically, the process is the same. And in this case, I'm going to use the power mode because that one is more powerful. It does a better verification process. So let me grab this and I'm going to jump into Pabbly Connect. This is where we're going to create the automation. If you want to check it out, link will be provided in the description. So we're going to create a brand new workflow. And for this, we're going to call it Reoon. Okay. But you can call it whatever you want. If it's going to be used on a giveaway, if it's going to be used on a form submission system, just call it whatever you want. So this is what we're going to do first. Choose the app. What is going to trigger? So we can use Reoon. So in this case, I'm going to use JotForm, which is a form builder. So I'm going to use JotForm. I'm going to select it here. I'm going to select it when the new response comes in. I'm going to grab this webhook. I'm going to go into JotForm. This is a quick form I created. Name and email, that's all I'm asking for. I'm going to go into settings, integrations. I'm going to search for webhook. I'm going to paste my webhook here. There we go. Let's complete the integration. There we go. Let's go ahead and finish. And over here on Pabbly Connect, it's waiting for a webhook response. So I'm going to fill out the form once. Okay. So I'm going to fill it out. Go on a new tab. There we go. I'm going to say my name. There we go. My email. I'm going to submit it. And let's go into Pabbly. We should be getting that response in a bit. There we go. We just got it. So here's the information. And we have the email and my name. So last name, first name, and my email. And there's another system here. Okay, so now let's connect with Reoon, right? So the next action, as of now, Reoon is not available in the native apps, but that's okay. We're going to use API. So search for API, select it. Here we go. We're going to use the get response. We're going to paste the link. Oh, not that link. The link from Reoon, this one right here. Remember, we're using the power mode. If you want to use the quick mode, just change the last word to quick. So let's select it here. Okay, so the first thing we need here is we need to replace the email section, okay? That's a variable. And that variable is gonna be grabbed from the response from this form in this case, okay? So here we go. This is gonna be dynamic every single time. So every single time that someone submits the form, it's gonna change the email there, okay? And then it needs our key. So this key, we're gonna grab it from Reoon. This is the way it's going to verify that it's actually us using it. So I'm going to create a new API key, and I'm going to call this delete because you're not going to be able to use it. I'm just going to use it for now. Okay, let me go ahead and grab this, copy it, and let's paste it here on the key. So that doesn't need to be dynamic. The key is a key. That's not going to change, okay? So I am going to do save and send a test request, and that should be working now, okay? Boom. I got connected with Reoon via API, and now it notes the domain is Gmail, the email it's this one, and let's scroll down here, and the status is safe. So it's a good email, obviously, because it's my email, right? Okay, now, what do you want to do with this? We have it verified now. Do we want to get alerted if it's a fake email? Do we want to do something with it? Do we want to jump into a next step? Well, we can add a filter here, for example. Filter out here. And we're going to say from this response, from the API that we've just created, let's scroll down here, save, okay? If this, and I'm going to say contains because it's a little bit safer. If this contains save, it's going to continue. So it's a filter, okay? So what happened here? I use a filter, and since this is a safe email, the filter says it's a successful, right? So it's going to continue to the next step, okay? But we can do the opposite. If it does not equal, okay, let's do it again. Okay, now it's an error, okay? That means that in this automation, someone's going to fill out the form. API is going to be doing its job with Reoon, and Reoon is going to say that this one is safe. So in this case, it's not going to continue because it's an error. So we're not going to continue the automation, okay? But if you do, you just set this contains or not contains, et cetera, equals or not equals. And that's going to be done if you want to continue or not. You can also use a router on this, okay? So if you want to use a router, that means that if it's safe, it's going to do this automation. If it's not safe, it's going to do a different automation, okay? So you can do this automation. But that is how you're going to connect your Reoon account with the automation. Now, how do I use the automation on Reoon? Well, what I do is when I run giveaways, when people sign up for my Facebook group, that email that they provide, it goes through Reoon. So it lets me know if it's real or not. And if it's real and if it's everything's okay, the automation, what it does, I use a filter. And what it does, if it's safe, so in this case, if it contains, I'm going to say safe. So this way it's going to continue. If it's good, what I do is I send it over to my email marketing system. So in this case, it's Send in Blue, which is now called Brevo. Yeah, that's what it's called. Probably ready here, Brevo. Yeah, here's Brevo. There we go. So if it's successful, it's going to add it to my email marketing system. That's the way I use Reoon right now. But I mean, there's several ways that you can use it, basically infinity ways, how you want to use this around, how you want to use the filters, how you want to use the automation, etc. But it's super easy to use the API key. Now, that's the way I use Reoon. I think it's the easiest way to get started using Reoon and just start using it on autopilot every single day without having to jump into Reoon and doing it manually. Because going here, you can obviously do the email verification by doing one by one, or you can do it by submitting a TXT, a CSV file. But that's if you have a list already. But if you are doing this on a constant go, like I said, if I run a giveaway right now, there's signups going on, and I want to verify those signups as they come along. So it depends how you want to use Reoon. But like I said, for this price, $79, this allowance that you get, I think it's pretty good. It's pretty inexpensive if you ask me, because if you pay month to month for a different service, well, it's way more expensive than this. Plus, there's a 60-day money-back guarantee. So that means if you don't like it, just go ahead and refund it. So go ahead and test that out and see for yourself. And go ahead and grab Pabbly and test it out together. If you want to do the automation. Does it work on Zapier? Yes, it does. Does it work on Make? Yes, it does via API. But Pabbly seems the one that I love the most. So it works fine there. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and let me know what you think in the comments. And that's a wrap.